دكتور عاطف،
It looks that Dr. Atef is not here yet, so I may ask if Dr. Ahmed Zaki, are you ready for the CSER pathway lecture?
I can.
Okay, Dr. Atef is here.
Dr. Atef is
okay,
here.
Fantastic. Okay, good. So.
I'm speaking about medical training initiative first, and after that, MMed. Okay? And this, what is in the schedule?
I trust you're right. So we can go ahead with the MTI pathway. Right. And after that, you're presenting the master's in medicine as per
our. Can you hear me now?
Yes.
Can you see my screen?
Yes, we can.
We just can't see your camera, Mr. Atef.
Can you see my screen now?
Perfect. We can see you and we can see your screen.
Okay. There's no video, so. Okay. Just to summarize the session, the first three subjects about PLAB, Medical Training Initiative, and the master in medicine are related to how to come to UK. The last two sessions about CCT and CSER is related to how to train in UK. So this to connect them together, okay? So I'm speaking about the medical training initiative. I have a problem with that. Okay. I have to start again, sorry. Okay, I'm okay now. So medical training initiative was designed to enable a small number of international medical and doctor and dental doctor to come to UK to practice British medicine and they develop their career in NHS for 2 years and they go back after that. So how about a medical training initiative post? The posts are mainly advertised as a clinical fellow or MTI. It is advertised at the level of senior clinical fellow, usually about 30,000 to 48,000 pounds. It is suitable for the suitable candidate are usually interviewed virtually. Okay, how can you create a post? The post has to be funded either by the overseas organization or by the employing trust. If a post is funded by the overseas organization, usually you can have agreement with the host trust to, and this usually you don't need an interview for that. You can make like a relationship between a trust and university or an institute to they fund their candidate and then they can get a job without interview. Or if the employing trust is funding it, then they have to go through the interview. Any post has to be approved by the deanery. That does not affect the training of UK trainee. But this is an advantage for the also for the person who is applying for MTI because we make sure that you have a proper training as well. So it does not affect the trainee and also make sure that this job will train you as well, not to use you for service. So the boss has to have training objective and a balancing job plan. Balancing job plan means that you have to do some service. That's why the trust employing you. But at the same time, you have to have training objective. You have to, if you want, for example, for ENT, you will do some ear surgery or rhinology. You have to make sure that in the beginning, and when you apply for a job, the training objectives are clear. What do you want from the job? And if the job is going to give you that, the things. Before shortlisting, usually all the applicants must pass OOT or the IELTS exam. Okay, so let's speak about the jobs in general. To apply for this job, you don't have to, you should not be a UK resident. I'll give you an example. I had been through the last few years, there is a gentleman, Egyptian doctor. He was married to an Egyptian lady who she's doing a master degree, MD in UK, and he's with her in a visa as a company person. You cannot apply for MTI if you with a visa already or if you're staying in UK. You have to pass the English test, and we discussed that, and Dr. Amr has discussed it. The most important thing again is you should not have sat or failed the black exam. If you start the black exam, if you sat or failed, you cannot apply for MTI. Have at least 3 year experience in a specialty. It's not good for this shops are not good for people who just qualified for medical school. You have to have a bit of experience, and you want to add to this experience. That's why the jobs are created, to add your experience. Another important point is that you have to be continuously working for the last 12 months in your specialty. So if you are not working, or then they will not consider you for the interview. And this is, I have seen in several times before as well, people who are coming for UK with their spouses or just do military service or something, to stop training. No, if you have to make sure that in the last 12 months, you have been in actual job. If you have a postgraduate degree, like a master's degree, it is recommended in some scheme. These jobs are usually for young doctor, not someone who had MD in Egypt or a very senior doctor. It's not, they will not be shortlisted. So usually within less than 10 year experience in your specialty, after that, I don't think you'll be shortlisted. So once you, if you're the person that was applying, has already seen registration, you can join through tier two visa. The GMC registration could be obtained as a black test, MRCB or MRCS. If you have MRCB or MRCS, this will help you more because it is a qualification and shows that you are serious in your career. So if you can make them, and they're not difficult exam, If you can do, while you are doing your master's degree, you'll be able to do MRCB, MRCS, rather than blood test. Blood test route, it is good for the people who just qualified for medical school, they're still fresh, they can pass a blood quickly, and then you can join the British system from the beginning, as CT1, CT2, and then this will be better for them to join from the beginning, and actually they might have a better chance to join a proper training program as well. If they don't have a GMC registration, then they have to go through the medical training initiative, and they have to be sponsored. The sponsorship usually by the Royal College, some trust like Manchester University Trust, we can sponsor people. Some organization like PABU, which is a British Association of Physicians of Indian Origin, they can sponsor. BIMA now is trying to be in the same position, and hopefully by next year, we'll be able to sponsor people to come for the MTI. And if they come through the MTI, they are issued tier 5 visa. This could be changed soon. So usually if you, for MTI candidate, the trust will apply for GMC registration because they don't have one. It takes about 4 to 6 weeks. And then after that, they will apply for a tier 5 visa through the Academy of the Royal College, take 4 to 6 weeks. And MTI will be signed by Health Education England, Associate Dean, and then will submit it again to the Association of Medical Royal College to get certificate of sponsorship for tier 5. Before COVID, the people who had came with through the tier 5 visa, they have to go outside the country if they want to carry on, and then apply for jobs and they come back as a tier 2. After the COVID, this has changed now. Actually, you can, within UK, you can change the, if you get a job or if you get extension through your trust, you can apply for a tier 2 visa without going out and coming back. For people who got the GMC registration, as I said, like with the MRCB, MRCS, or BLAB, tier 2 should be issued for the contract, which is maximum of 3 years, for example. The people who actually, there's apart from the MTI now, people who got MRCB, MRCS, they can apply for a clinical fellow straight away. And even if they don't have a visa, the trust can issue them a visa straight away as well. So these people, they should not look only for MTI, they should look for jobs, which as senior clinical fellow. In this point here, I want to discuss about senior clinical fellow and junior clinical fellow. When they apply, you look at the word junior clinical fellow, these people actually are equivalent to SHO or CT1, which is, this mean you are, it's not, it's mainly service job. If you are very experienced and maybe 6-7 years after you were qualified, I don't think you should apply for a junior clinical job, even if you shortlisted or if you offer the job. The reason for that, the job is mainly a clerical job. You are looking after patient, inpatient. You're doing call, covering multiple specialty, covering medicine, covering fishing auxiliary, covering surgery. And you are mainly dealing with emergency medicine, like cardiac arrest, renal failure. And people who are left for a surgeon, for example, who has not done it for a long time, they'll find it very difficult to fit in this job. And I have seen some people going to GMC because they could not do the job. And if you fall in someone racist, which is racism is very present in NHS at the moment, then he can stop you working and then stop your career. So if you are experienced, if you get a master's degree, if you get a master's, apply for a senior clinical job. Don't apply for a junior job, because this junior job, you will not be able to do it properly. Vice versa, if someone just qualified and doesn't have enough experience in a job, you should not apply for a senior clinical fellow, because when you come to the job, you are supposed to do surgery, you are supposed to look to do a higher grade or to cover emergency. For example, for ENT, you have to do tracheostomy, you have to do ear surgery. If you cannot do the job as well, then this will be stop your career here. So apply for the job which is appropriate for you and ask for advice. Ask for advice from people here, ask advice from subspecialty. I'm sure everyone will know some person in UK who's working can tell you apply or not apply, and the people can offer this service. So in short, if you pass the English test, if you have no GMC registration, you apply for tier 5. If you have GMC registration, you apply for tier 2 visa, and you can apply for senior clinical firm. I think that's the end of my presentation. I made it short, but I hope I covered everything. Thank you.
Thank you, Dr. Atef, for telling us this talk. Very, very comprehensive. We're going to keep the questions at the end of the session. Our next speaker is going to tell us about the CESAR pathway. And I'm honored to introduce...
Hamad, I said I'm doing MMed now.
Oh, yeah, okay. Dr. Atef AlKholy is going to tell us about the Master's in Medicine, which is MMed. This initially was going to be given to us by Dr. Sameh Abdullatif, but unfortunately he's not going to be able to do that today. So kindly, Dr. Atef has agreed to do the session.
Just one second, prepare my... Just one second, Muhammad, I'm just trying to